And we have also done, in 2 years ago, this first study on regions 2020, where climate change has been identified as one of the four major challenges. And this study clearly shows that there will be impacts. So we have something which is very important, I think, for good policy, which is a set of information on the future vision of the challenges. We also know from this study that this impact will be extremely asymmetric, so that also requires tailor-made responses, that also requires this local and regional approach to the responses. But in general, we see that basically more than one-third of European population is living today in regions which will be belong to the group of strongly affected regions, strongly affected by the climate change. So that shows seriousness of the situation, and that also means that it shouldn't be a surprise to us that 85% of the Europeans believe that climate change should be taken seriously by politicians. It is an important challenge. So I think it is extremely important to see that what is on the horizon is also an argument in favor of harnessing the cohesion policy into this adaptation and mitigation set of policies. And also in the cohesion policy for this 2007-13, in fact, we have 100 billion euro, which is 30% more or less of the policy allocated to environment-related investment, which a lot of it is also, I would say, directly or indirectly linked to the climate change, especially if you think of all the risks or if you think of the water sector, but also on the erosion of coastal areas and also the investment in the related to risk into the protection or against the prevention or protection against the floods and droughts type of disaster. So I would say that it is, the beginning is there. I mean, so we are not really facing something that is unknown or that is not understood today. What we probably need, and this could be the request to the European Commission, to have now, as the evaluation of 2000-2006 is coming to the end, to have further step in evaluating maybe the first years of 2007-13 from this point of view, and to see also how those categories of potential investment that we have as a commitment in programs from the member states, how this is approached in practice, to see whether we are really moving on this in this area. Now, singling out cohesion policy is certainly very important. That's my when I think on the future. But it's absolutely clear that it's not enough. That it's not only the cohesion policy that should be here seen as a very important policy because of its financial also instrument. But I would say that more in more general terms, European policies and European projects should be climate proof. Because we see very often when we ask now people to do the assessment of the cost and benefits of a project, they can look today as sufficient, but if you take into account the potential climate-related risk, this can look differently, and that's why I think we also have to see that how the economic and environmental viability of a project looks when we take into account the climate change. So all those potential risks related to the climate change, they must be integrated into the design of the policy, but also into the project, especially major projects, but not only, because we have a lot of, at local level, a lot of relatively small projects in the infrastructure related to water or risks or transport where the value is much lower, but there is also this element of climate change related risk. So I would say that at all levels of governance, I think we should have this integrated approach that would allow us to see also the potential risks strengthened in the future. And that's why for this we need the involvement of what we call all stakeholders, which is not only those who design projects or implement projects, not only just local or regional authorities, but also the research, the industry, the consumers, the private, the public, in fact, all those also who are capable of awareness raising. We need a lot of good practice sharing, we need guidelines, so we need methodologies, we need also very concrete tools. But I clearly see from the cohesion policy, which is this horizontal, place-based, integrated policy, that in fact climate proofing will be needed for all relevant policy areas. That it just it's not enough to look at a cohesion policy, and we will need a lot of climate proof check lists for different policies. They might be slightly different depending on the policy. And we were also still in the Commission discussing, and I'm sure that the Commission is moving on this as well, is also how to integrate the climate proof into the impact assessment, or especially adaptation aspects, how to include it into the impact assessment. The challenge was, as we discussed it, I remember a year ago, in fact, the challenge is that we don't know enough. I mean, it's probably surprising that new challenges come, and we are really realizing that our knowledge, and not just a superficial knowledge, but real knowledge, is too limited to be sure that we to be able also to have a good, wise, and efficient and effective policy. So we have to try, I think through research, there's no other way how to do it, to make a major progress on translating climate impacts into economic terms. And we have to look again into the content of costs content of benefits, and this requires also, I would say, sometimes a mental change. So we need research that would lead us to better information, that would allow us also to identify the best measures for individual policies, the best adaptation measures for the policies, that would also clarify, as I said, costs and benefits. So we need a lot of research on understanding of the challenge, clearly, also on the quantification of this challenge, to know how to measure it, especially that is a challenge that is very often something which might be on the horizon, and there's no experience yet. And we need also research that would allow us to better understand impacts and all the links in the economy, and to better measure risks. But we also, I think, need to have a good, a new look again into the environmental impact assessment, maybe, and to see the good practice there, and how can we also make climate proofing there as a good practice, or best practice, as some people say. So that there is a lot of, I would say, efforts needed, which are more on the methodology measuring side, not only on the political side. And for this, we don't have too much time, but there's also another element which we have to introduce here, which is the time pressure, a lot of understanding. But I think all this can be done. All this, on all that, we can make progress relatively fast, provided that we have an effective and continuous dialogue between experts, with practitioners, I think, with policy makers, civil servants, and of course, I have to add, at all levels of European governance, because as I said, it would be very difficult to prove today that we can face the challenge of both adaptation and mitigation without the involvement of local and regional, not only authorities, but authorities and partners there. And this is the level where the partnership is I think, works better than at any other level of governance. So probably one should say that's still a long way to go, but I think we already made first steps.